myself, the people say.
Just stop, stop, stop. She's asking a question.
You say people, there are some people, I hate myself. Right? I hate myself. Okay? And I want to commit suicide. Like that they say. So in reality, what they are saying is that I am not ready, I'm not in a comfortable situation to accept myself as what I am. I deserve something better. Okay? Right? That I which deserves better is the real self. Okay? I am not able to accept my condition is the limitation imposed by the body and mind and society. But they don't know that there is a real self which is blissful, and they are mixing up the real self with the body, mind. And they are not able to tolerate the condition of the self. Okay? So because deep inside they want something, a better status or treatment for the self. Okay? So when they say, I hate myself, they are really hating their tendencies, vasanas, which are causing them feel limited. In reality, that's actually expression of love for the self only. Misdirected. Misunderstanding is there. They're not able to accept the nature of the self, because the nature of self is blissfulness, infinity. Deep inside, they know. And what they are there today, because of their social conditioning or religious conditioning or family conditioning, they feel very constrained. And that constraint is not acceptable to the self. That's why I hate myself in whatever condition what I am, which means I really love my true self. Not, the condition is not acceptable. See, in reality, the people who are committing suicide, they're all, it's all spiritual crisis only. People who get into mental depression, they're all spiritual crisis only. They are looking for alleviating the suffering. Okay? So in some way, through drugs or suicide, whatever is that. Why? Because suffering is not natural to myself, true self. But they don't know what is true self and what is the assumed self. They are mixing up these two. So real jnana is who am I will free them from the suffering. That's one thing. Then second thing is there are people who take to drugs. Okay, the drugs or alcohol. There's also a sort of a sense of spiritual crisis only. Because they want to forget some situation life, some suffering. They want to get out of the suffering, because suffering is not natural to my inner self. That deep inside, that's a feeling. To get out of the suffering, they try to get into drugs, addiction. So all the crisis in the world today is really a spiritual crisis, where your self, real self is for, real self is ignored, and your false self of the body and mind becomes dominant. And being false self, it also undergoes suffering. And you mix up the false self with the real self. And deep inside, you are not accepting the limitation imposed on the real self. So that's where the crisis comes. The mental disorder or a psychological disorder or drug addiction or attempts to suicide, all of them. If they had given a spiritual education, probably we can save them. See, this is what happened in case of Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada, when he went to America, and he started chanting Hare Krishna, without knowing who will come, who will not come. At that time, America was going through a lot of what we call so-called hippie movement. People were addicted to drugs. Okay, American government was spending millions of dollars on reforming people who are addicted to drugs. These people, they started God's name, and they started feeling relieved. They started feeling the joy. So their drug addiction was to get a joy from something which is not possible. The real joy comes from connecting with the self. So most of the crisis, whether suicide or mental disorder, is a crisis of a spiritual crisis rather than a spiritual crisis induced by the social conditions. Because we learn a lot of conditioning happens in the society, and this conditioning is what actually causes this suffering. Okay. Okay. Now see, what you said is, people hate, then they say, I hate myself, I want to kill myself. Actually, they are loving their self. They are not able to tolerate the conditions imposed on the self. Now, who is imposing the condition? Their own mind. Okay. So that condition they want to terminate, but they are not able to separate out the condition from the self. They will try to find out another solution, whether maybe in the drugs, maybe in the form of suicide, trying to get rid of the problem. But reality is, even this getting rid of the problem is also love for the self only, but unconsciously manifesting. So the many of these deep crises in life is spiritual crisis only. They're not, the conditioning is happening because of society. Okay, too much of conditioning happens by our external society, what it is, and we start believing and living these conditions as true. But deep inside, there's a pull from the self, which says this is not okay. Right? It's almost like a squeezing a rubber ball. When you squeeze the rubber ball will want to expand. So deep inside, my self is prompting me to expand rather than contract. And I'm not able to accept it. Nobody can save you. Not an animal also is not able to accept it. Okay. Animal also, if you put some condition, they can't accept it. Because deep inside, this self, which is infinity, which is Satchidananda Rupa. So the pull of the self is there. Then when people say, I hate myself, I want to kill myself, they don't want to kill themselves. They want to kill the condition which is causing them trouble. Maybe mental disorder, maybe addiction. But the problem is they are not able to separate out the self from the conditioning. They think the self is miserable, but deep inside the pull of the self is there, which says, no, this is not acceptable. So the love for the self is prompting all these things. If they are able to understand the real nature of self and separate out the conditioning from the self, a lot of people get a benefit. It's not easy because many people have to get access to spiritual counseling, spirituality, which is difficult. I heard one movement called Alcoholics Anonymous, AAA. So there was a alcoholic, he was a rich man, and he was addicted to alcohol. And then he was taken to a psychiatrist. At that time, I think a great psychiatrist was there in America, Carl Jung or somebody. So he got a treatment for a long time, but his health condition started deteriorating. Doctor said, if you drink anymore, you will die. He is not able to give up on drinking. Psychiatrist told, I have done my best. I have done counseling. Nothing is working out. Now God only can save you. Then he came home. The condition was so desperate, he started praying to God, please save me. Suddenly, his habit pattern for alcoholism started dropping. And he became free from the alcoholism. Now he started connecting with the spirit, inner spirit, in whatever way you call. Okay. Then he came to Carl Jung, the psychiatrist of that time. He told him. Then they started a group therapy where alcoholics, instead of counseling, they pray to God. They try to connect with the inner spirit. And they found tremendous good results. So that's why it became a movement worldwide called AA, Alcoholics Anonymous movement. So somewhere you have to connect with the inner self, somewhere we have to connect with the higher self, God. So that gives a freedom. And this we have heard in many other stories also. Many of the time, deep crisis in life makes a person deeply spiritual. Okay, they realize that where they are missing in life. That happened in the case of Tulsidas. Tulsidas was actually so much attached to his wife. His wife had gone to her mother's place. Tulsidas could not tolerate the separation from his wife. He swam across the river, which was in floods, and he used a wooden log and crossed the river. Then his wife's room was in the first floor. He climbed that using a creeper. And wife saw that, and she saw out of the window, and she was shocked. He had used a dead body for swimming, and the creeper was not a snake. So she told him, if you had even 1% of this love for God, you would have been freed. You would have such a joy in life. And immediately it transformed into Tulsidas. Okay, his love for God. Actually, everybody has a love for the inner self. When you don't recognize the inner self, it gets directed on the other person. And we try to get happiness from the other person. Suddenly recognition, and he became Tulsidas, a great poet. So many times in the deep crisis in spiritual crisis in life, we start discovering the inner spirituality. And this is a sort of nature also. Okay. Nature also like that. See, like a hen has an egg. Okay. The egg is there as a protection for the chicken inside. So one day the chicken grows, the egg has to break. Okay, egg has to break. Similarly, the butterfly, no, or caterpillar builds a cocoon around. And one day it is ready for the butterfly, the cocoon will break. Like that, we have a cocoon inside around us. The cocoon is called ego. Okay. Each of us have a cocoon. It's a shell. We don't recognize it's a shell. We think it's real. The cocoon gives a protection to us. In terms of it builds our, it pampers us. It helps us to build our ego and build our, what I call, life. Build our story. And a point will come when you are ready, that cocoon will break. That's actually your spiritual discovery. Okay. It's almost like the nature gives the ego is also a god, divine or universal creation of the God. It is given as a sort of protection for you to develop certain level, mature, and then at certain point it breaks. Maybe in this lifetime or many lifetimes, I don't know when, but it breaks. When it breaks, your spiritual life begins. Really, spiritual life, you open up. The inner self, you open up. It may happen in one life or many lifetimes, but it will eventually happen. It's this. The ego is like a shell around a coconut. The coconut has two layers of shells. One is husk, right? Husk, no? It's called a husk. And inner shell. So, in reality, these are not useful, but they are useful. They protect the inner kernel until the inner kernel gets the right environment for sprouting and becoming a tree. After that, these will disintegrate. Like that, ego is a sort of shell which is created by nature for us. And we feel that person is egoistic and all. That ego is protecting that person, protecting that personality till a point of time that he is mature enough to reach that higher level or inner self. But otherwise, we feel that person is, and then there's the question of why there is evil in the world. This ego is just a protective mechanism. It doesn't know who is good, who is God, what is right, what is wrong. Many times you get wrong directions as a protection mechanism. It's like you can think ego is like a dog, protection dog. The dog doesn't know who is policeman, who is thief. It will keep on barking. Like that, this ego is responsible for negativity in the world. And we call this evil or whatever is it. But reality is that ego is given as a protective mechanism. It doesn't know. It's unconscious protective mechanism. So finally, sometime it will break, opening up the inner divinity. When it will do, when it will happen, we don't know. Sometimes it takes many lifetimes. Some people discover true inner spirit in times of moments of crisis in life.